वेलकम टू मैक्स ऑनलाइन क्लास। फिफ्थ सम। इफ द डिफरेंस ऑफ द रूट्स ऑफ द इक्वेशन 2x स्क्वायर माइनस ए प्लस 1x प्लस ए माइनस 1 इज इक्वल टू 0 इज इक्वल टू देयर प्रोडक्ट, देन प्रूव दैट ए इज इक्वल टू 2। हियर द डिफरेंस ऑफ द रूट्स ऑफ द इक्वेशन इज इक्वल टू द प्रोडक्ट। डिफरेंस ऑफ द रूट्स ऑफ द इक्वेशन इज इक्वल टू देयर प्रोडक्ट। हियर द रूट्स आर आल्फा एंड बीटा। देयर डिफरेंस, डिफरेंस मीन्स आल्फा माइनस बीटा। Alpha minus beta is equal to their product. Product means multiply. So alpha into beta. Alpha minus beta is equal to alpha beta. That is given in the question. So take it as 1. Here the given equation is 2x square minus a plus 1x plus a minus 1 is equal to 0. Here a is equal to 2. B is equal to minus a plus 1. C is equal to a minus 1. This is a, b, c. Okay, then find alpha and beta are the roots, then find sum of the roots. Sum of the roots is equal to alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Its formula is minus b by a is equal to substitute the value. Here already your minus n is there, so minus into minus plus, so a plus 1. A plus 1 divided by 2. Mark it as number 2. Then find the product of the roots. Product of the roots is equal to c by a. Here c is equal to a minus 1 by 2. A minus 1 by 2. Mark it as third equation. Then the from the equation 1, alpha minus beta is equal to alpha beta. From equation 1, alpha minus beta is equal to alpha beta. Squaring on both sides. So you have alpha minus beta whole square is equal to alpha beta whole square. Alpha beta whole square. This is the form of a minus b whole square. So expand a square plus b square minus 2ab. So alpha square plus beta square minus 2 alpha beta is equal to alpha beta whole square. Then adding 4 alpha beta on both sides. Adding 4 alpha beta on both sides. So you have alpha square plus beta square minus 2 alpha beta plus 4 alpha beta is equal to alpha beta whole square plus 4 alpha beta. Here subtract 4 alpha beta minus 2 alpha beta is 2 alpha beta. So alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta is equal to alpha beta whole square plus 4 alpha beta. So this can be written as alpha beta whole square. This is the form of a square plus b square plus 2ab. So this can be written as a plus b whole square. So alpha plus beta whole square. Alpha plus beta whole square. The place of alpha plus beta whole square, substitute the value alpha plus beta is a plus 1 by 2. A plus 1 by 2 whole square is equal to in the place of alpha beta, substitute a minus 1 by 2 whole square plus 4 into the place of alpha beta, substitute a minus 1 by 2. Okay. Then squaring both numerator and denominator, so you have a plus 1 whole square divided by 4 equal to a minus 1 whole square by 4 plus 4 into a minus 1 by 2. Multiply the whole equation by 4. So you have a plus 1 whole square is equal to a minus 1 whole square plus multiply the whole equation by 4. So cancel by 2. So 2 already that 4 is there. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into a minus 1. 8 into a minus 1. Expand a square plus 2a plus 1 is equal to, this is the form of a minus b whole square, so a square minus 2ab plus b square. So this can be written as a square minus 2a plus 1 plus multiply this 8 inside the bracket, so you have 8 into a, 8a minus a, 8. Cancel a square cancel, a square cancel, 2a. Plus 1 plus 1 cancel, plus 1 cancel, so 2a, 8a minus 2a, 8a minus 2a, 6a minus 8. Okay, bring this 8 other side, 2a bring this side, so it becomes 6a minus 2a is equal to 8. 6a minus 2a, 4a, 4a is equal to 8, so a is equal to 2. 8 by 4, 2, hence proved. Sixth sum, find the condition that one of the roots of ax square plus bx plus c may be negative of the other. One root is negative of the other. One root is negative of the other. Second one is one root is thrice the other. And the third condition is one root is reciprocal of the other. Here you make use of these three conditions and then find the answers. First consider ax square plus bx plus c. Then alpha beta. Alpha beta is equal to minus b by a. Alpha beta is equal to c by a. First one. Let us take the first one. One root is negative of the other. One root is negative of the other. Let us take one root be alpha and the other root be minus alpha. So let alpha and minus alpha are the roots of the equation. Then find sum of the roots. Sum of the roots is equal to alpha minus alpha. Alpha minus alpha is equal to minus b by a. Alpha minus alpha means 0. 0 is equal to minus b by a. Minus b by a. Then multiply the minus sign. So there is no minus sign. So cross multiply 0 into a, 0. So b is equal to 0. So if you use the first condition, you will get b is equal to 0. Then consider the second condition. The root is, one root is thrice the other. One root is thrice the other. So let us take one root be alpha and the other root be 3 alpha. One root be alpha and the other root be 3 alpha are the roots of the equation. Then find sum of the roots. Sum of the roots is equal to alpha plus 3 alpha is equal to minus b by a. Minus b by a. Alpha plus 3 alpha is 4 alpha. 4 alpha is equal to minus b by a. Minus b by a. Then alpha is equal to, bring this 4 other side. It comes under the division minus b by 4a. Minus b by 4a. Then find product of the roots. Product of the roots is equal to alpha into 3 alpha. Multiply these two roots. Alpha into 3 alpha is equal to c by a. So 3 into alpha alpha square. So 3 alpha square is equal to c by a. So in the place of alpha, substitute minus b by 4a. So 3 into minus b by 4a whole square is equal to c by a. Squaring on both, no, square the numerator and denominator. Square the numerator and denominator. So minus becomes a plus. So b square 4a square. B square by 4a square. So 3 into b square by 4a square means 4a whole square means 16a square is equal to c by a. Multiply the 3. So 3b square by 16a square is equal to c by a. Cross multiply. So 3b square is equal to 16a square c by a. A cancel. So 3b square is equal to 16ac. 3b square is equal to 16ac. Then let us take the third condition. Third condition is one root is reciprocal of the other. One root may be the reciprocal of the other. So let us take one root be alpha and its reciprocal is 1 by alpha. One root be alpha and its reciprocal is 1 by alpha. Then find product of the roots. Product of the roots equal to alpha into 1 by alpha. Alpha into 1 by alpha is equal to c by a. Alpha alpha cancel. So 1 is equal to c by a. So c is equal to a. C is equal to a. Eighth sum. Discuss the nature of the roots. Discuss the nature of the roots of the equation. Subdivision 1. Minus x square plus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. Minus x square plus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. This equation is of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So here a is equal to minus 1. Coefficient of x square. A is equal to minus 1. B is equal to 3. Coefficient of x is b. So c is equal to constant term. So c is equal to 1. Then we want to find the nature of the roots. The formula to find the nature of the roots is b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac is equal to, substitute the value. In the place of b, substitute 3. 3 whole square minus 4. In the place of a, substitute minus 1. In the place of c, substitute 1. So 3 square means 9. 9 minus into minus plus 4 into 1, 4. 9 plus 4, 13. 13 is greater than 0, positive, greater than 0. So the roots are real and distinct. The roots are real and distinct. Subdivision 2. 4x square minus x minus 2 is equal to 0. So the equation is of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Here a is equal to 4, b is equal to minus 1, c is equal to minus 2. formula to find the nature of the roots is this b square minus 4ac is equal to substitute the values. In the place of b, substitute minus 1, minus 1 whole square minus 4. In the place of a, substitute 4. In the place of c, substitute minus 2, which is equal to minus 1 whole square means plus 1. Minus into minus plus 4, 4 are 16, 16 into 2, 32. 1 plus 32, 33. 33 is greater than 0. So it is a positive, so the greater than 0, so the roots are real and distinct. Subdivision 3. Subdivision 3. 9x square plus 5x plus 9x square plus 5x is equal to 0. Here, a is equal to 9, b is equal to 5, c is equal to 0. Formula is b square minus 4ac is equal to 5 square minus 4 in the place of a, substitute 9, the place of c, substitute 0. 5 square means 25, 4 into 9, 36, 36 into 0, 0. So 25, 25 is greater than 0. So the roots are real and distinct. Ninth sum, without sketching the graph, find whether the graph of the following functions will intersect the x-axis and if so, in how many points. Without sketching the graph. Without sketching the graph means without drawing the graph. Find whether the graph will intersect. Find whether the graph will intersect the x-axis or not. If it intersect, find how many points. That is the question. First sum. Y is equal to x square plus x plus 2. Y is equal to x square plus x plus 2. Here, intersect at x-axis. Intersect at x-axis means put y is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0. So this becomes x square plus x plus 2 is equal to 0. Here we are not able to factorize. So use quadratic formula. Use quadratic formula. So this equation is of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, c is equal to 2. Then its quadratic formula is x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Substitute all the values in the formula. So you have minus 1 plus or minus root of 1 square minus 4 into 1 into 2 divided by 2, which is equal to minus 1 plus or minus 1 square means 1 minus 4 into 1, 4, 4 2s are 8. 1 minus 8 minus 7 divided by 2. Now look at the square root, inside the square root. Negative integer. Negative integer means the roots are imaginary. The roots are imaginary. That is less than 0, so the roots are imaginary. So it does not intersect. Graph, it does not intersect. Subdivision 3. Y is equal to x square plus 6x plus 9. Put y is equal to 0. So this equation becomes x square plus 6x plus 9 is equal to 0. Factorize here, sum is equal to 6 and the product is equal to 9. So this can be written as x plus 3 into x plus 3 is equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 3 comma minus 3. Minus 3 comma minus 3, same root. We got the same root. The roots are equal. So it intersect at one point. It intersect at one point. We got the same root minus 3, so it intersect at one point. Subdivision 2. Y is equal to x square minus 3x minus 7. Similarly, put y is equal to 0. So this equation becomes x square minus 3x minus 7 is equal to 0. Here also we are not able to factorize. Use quadratic formula. Before that, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 3, c is equal to minus 7. Write the quadratic formula x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Substitute the values. So x is equal to 3 plus or minus minus 3 whole square minus 4 into 1 minus 7 divided by 2 into 1. So 3 plus or minus square root of minus 3 whole square means 9. Minus into minus plus 4 sevens are 28. 28 divided by 2. So which is equal to 3 plus or minus square root of 9 plus 28, 37 divided by 2, positive. B square minus 4ac is greater than 0, so it intersect at 2 points. Here, if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0 means it intersect at 2 points. if it is less than 0, negative means it does not intersect. Okay, if you got a equal root means it intersect at one point. Tenth sum, write f of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 4 in completed square form. Write f of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 4 in completed square form. Consider the equation f of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 4. Take down the middle term 5x. Take down the middle term 5, coefficient of x. Take down the middle term. Consider the coefficient of x, 5. Divide by 2. So if you divide by 2, you'll get 5 by 2. So add and subtract 5 by 2 whole square. Add and subtract 5 by 2 whole square. So this becomes x square plus 5x plus 4 plus 5 by 2 whole square minus 5 by 2 whole square. Now x square plus 5x plus 5 by 2 whole square is in the form of a square plus 2ab plus b square. A square plus 2ab plus b square. So this can be written as a plus b whole square. X a is equal to x, b is equal to 5 by 2. So x plus 5 by 2 whole square. And then write down the remaining terms. 4 minus 5 by 2 whole square means 5 by 2 into 5 by 2. 5 by 2 into 5 by 2, 25 by 4. Then take LCM. The last two terms, take LCM. So x plus 5 by 2 whole square plus 4 is the LCM, cross multiply 16 minus 25. So this can be written as x plus 5 by 2 whole square, 16 minus 25, 9 minus 9, minus 9 by 4, which is equal to x plus 5 by 2 whole square minus 9 by 2 can be written as 3 by 2 whole square. 3 by 2 whole square. Now this is the form of completed square form. Completed square form means f of x is equal to x square minus a square. Y is equal to x square minus a square. F of x is equal to x square minus a square. This is, you keep it as fully as x. So x square minus a square.